My name is Deepak. I do all of those things mentioned on the slide next to me with varying and questionable degrees of success. Why I'm here before you today is to help address a question that a lot of us face when we start working, especially after we graduate out of business schools, which is, I'm bored. I don't know what to do. And that's strange. It's such a strange thing to say in an era like today, because there is so much to do. There is a lot out there. And with the advent of the internet, it provides you a platform like never before to express yourself. It's a great platform for you to do things, learn things. The reason why I want to talk about this is drawing from personal experience. I went to one of the finest business schools in the country, if you can call MICA a business school. And I, at the end of 2 years, I had a diploma, I had a job. But I had little else to show for it. I went to MICA with all sorts of dreams. I said, I want to do this, I want to do this, I want to compose this, I want to make that, I want to write that. And at the end of it, nothing really came to fruition. This, despite having more time on my hands than the guy who manages the ticket booth for a Ram Gopal Verma movie. So now to help take this forward, I want to introduce a few terms to you. Now, these terms are not words that you guys are alien to. These terms are words that you guys already know the dictionary definition of. All right? One is called skill, the other is called passion, and the third is called knowledge. You guys okay with this? Yeah? Now, let's have a look at these three words. Skill. Skill is something that you're good at. Yeah? It could be something that you like doing, or it could be something that you don't like doing. But either way, it's something that you know how to do, and chances are you're above average at it. Yeah? Passion. Passion is simple. It's something you love. It's something that brings a smile to your face when you talk about it. It's something that you really like. It's something that your friends know you like. It's something that you proudly list on your Facebook profile. It's something that you'd like to get a tattoo of. It could be someone you want to get a tattoo of. It's something that you hope that your secret Santa knows about you. It's something that you would proudly talk about in a conversation with other people who share the same passion. Passions are awesome. Passions are fantastic. Passions could be something that you don't know how to do, like music, for instance. You may enjoy music, but you may not know how to play an instrument. It could be something that you think you're very good at, but you actually might not be. These are some of the common passions that people list that they have. It helps if you can be a little more specific in terms of what is it that you're passionate about. I have three out of those four, and judging by the size of my stomach, I'm guessing you know which is the odd one out over here. Knowledge. Knowledge is something that you know, all right? Knowledge is something that you know. It's not just a superficial knowledge, but you know the subject deep enough. It's something that you might even be equipped enough to edit the Wikipedia article about. If you're a business school student, it might be something that you choose to write your dissertation or your thesis about. It could be something, skill and knowledge are two very different things. Okay, you could be skilled at something without having knowledge about it. Like, for example, you might be skilled at playing the guitar, but you may not know who Eddie Van Halen is, in which case my personal opinion is you should stop playing the guitar, but that's another conversation for another day. It could be something that you're not very passionate about. Like, for example, mutual funds. I am yet to meet one person who is passionate about mutual funds despite working in the industry for 5 years. You're never going to get a guy, oh, this tattoo, this is just the NAV of the HDFC top 200 over the last 5 years. This guy is never going to, you'll never going to find this guy. Okay? Simple. Three simple words: skill, passion, and knowledge. Now, what I want you guys to do is something a little interesting. Okay? I want you guys to take a piece of paper or smartphones being this generation, and I want you to list down two skills that you think you have, two things that you know you're passionate about, and two things that you think you have a fair amount of knowledge in. You don't need to be an expert on it. It'll be something you can build on later. All right? Now what we're going to try and do is something a little interesting. Okay? By the way, you might have the same thing for all three, You might have different things for all three, like you might be skilled at PowerPoint, you might be passionate about fantasy fiction, and you might be knowledgeable about finance, that's fine. It could be the same thing, it could be totally different thing. But take time out and find out what your two of each are. It could be something that you're passionate about and you're knowledgeable about, but you're not very skilled in, like music, for instance. It could be something that you're very skilled at and very passionate about, but you have absolutely no working knowledge of how it happens, like drinking beer. Don't laugh just yet. And it could be something that you're very skilled at and very knowledgeable about, but you're not passionate about it at all. A lot of day jobs fall into this space, all right? So there you have it, skill, passion, and knowledge. Now let's see what we can do with this. Now we're going to try and make this a little interesting. I don't have a fancy word or term for this, so I'm just going to call this the merging of two worlds. It's a technique that's worked for me for the last 5 years, and I'd like to share this little bit of knowledge with you. Now, in my experience, interesting things happen when two things come together. We all know what happens when these two things come together, something magical is created. When these two things come together, something magical is created. When these two things come together, something okay, it doesn't always work. It doesn't always work, I'm just saying. Okay? What we want to do now is, take a skill that you believe you have, and merge it with either another skill, a passion, or knowledge. Okay? Let's take a few examples so this becomes clearer for you. For a lot of us, we believe that a skill would be writing, okay? Suppose another skill that we have is cooking. Hey, you can actually write about cooking. Where? It could be a magazine, it could be a blog, it could be anywhere. Suppose your passion is rock music. Hey, you can write about rock music, you can write gig reviews, you can write album reviews, you can interview people. There's a lot you can do. Suppose your knowledge is about finance, sure, you can write about finance. Suppose your skill was writing in a comedic fashion. Now that becomes interesting. How many people do you know write in a comedic fashion about finance? Suddenly you have an idea for a satire series. So this becomes very interesting. Let's take another example. Suppose your skill is photography, all right? And cooking, gigs, and electronics. You see how interesting niches are being formed over here? These are all now nice, interesting ideas that you can form. All right, a couple more examples to make this a little more interesting. Suppose your skill is writing again, and don't laugh. Suppose your passion is beer, and your knowledge, you have fairly knowledgeable about beer. What stops you from becoming an authority, a thought leader, as the industry likes to call it, on beer in India? There are guys who do this for wine, and they are very respected among the alcohol industry in the country. So examples like this are great things for you guys to try out. Suppose your passion is cooking, and suppose your skill is cooking and your passion is rock music, you may think they are two totally different things which you'll never meet, but hey, you can actually create recipes that are rock music themed, right? And you may even start a blog about it. You may even start a restaurant about it. Invite me. I'd love to come and try the smoke on the water. Okay? My personal stories, I'd like to think that I'm a little bit skilled in cartooning, and I had a bit of knowledge about the MBA world and MBA life, having lived it for close to a decade. So I started a cartoon series for Pagal Guy, which was based on MBA comics and MBA life, and hopefully some of you guys would have seen that. It became the only comic about MBA life in the country. I believed I was good at cartooning, and a passion was the independent rock music scene in the country. And I created a series for NH7, which was called Out of Tune, which was one of the only pieces of humor content based on the independent rock music scene in the country. Interesting niches that I got to. Another experiment that I had for a while, I believed that a skill was making presentations, and I had knowledge about advertising. For a while, I had this sort of side project where I tried making comics about the Indian advertising scene in the form of Microsoft PowerPoint presentations. So an interesting little experiment which lasted for a while. Hopefully, I'll revive it. Just a few things. I've shared a lot with you. Just a few things that I'd like you guys to keep in mind while you try this experiment out for yourselves. First, you gotta live for your passion. Like, you gotta live for it. If your passion is hiking, then by Wednesday, you've got to start getting an itch and you've got to start researching on places to go to. Okay, you have to live for your passion. It means more than just a superficial knowledge on the surface. You can't like it on the surface. You gotta really love it. A lot of us, we list down a lot of passions in our CVs when we are going for interviews, and we just regurgitate the Wikipedia article about it when we are asked to comment on it during interviews. That's not what we are looking at over here. You need to really love what you love, what you state you love. Okay. Second thing, you have to be your own harshest critic. You have to always introspect. You have to always try to better your own work. Remember, you may be able to fool some editors and some readers some of the time, but you will never be able to fool yourself. You have to be hard on yourself. You have to keep pushing your own boundary. Third thing, I know this sounds like a cliche, but this is one of the most important things. When you graduate from a B school, you'll have a maximum of 5 hours per day. If you live in Bombay, that's 2 hours per day, all right? You need to learn how to manage time, and it's really not very difficult. I've seen a lot of people complain about commute. Commute can actually be an interesting thing. I spend my time commuting, thinking of ideas for cartoons and thinking of ideas for stand-up comedy. In fact, most of the material for this TEDx speech was conceptualized in the back of an auto rickshaw using in a whole diary, as you can see. Lastly, just give it a shot. Just give it a shot. There's nothing out there stopping you. There's so much to do. Like I said in the beginning of the speech, the internet has given us so much space to do things, so much space to try things. Each of you are good at something. Each of you are passionate about something. Just put two worlds together. Just give it a shot. Things will happen. And a lot of things might materialize out of that. You may have a blog about it. Hey, someday you may even start making money out of it. And might even be invited to give a TEDx talk about it. My name is Deepak, that's my Twitter handle. Thank you so much guys for having me. Enjoy the rest of the show. Thank you.